Hello dear students, so this is Professor Vikas Madikai, Director of Training and Placement, KLS VDIT here. Now the very basic purpose of making this video is to share some information related to a fuel Coursera free online courses for all the students of KLS VDIT. So in this video, I'll just brief you about what are the various courses that are available under the platform of fuel Coursera and how you can register to all those courses and how you can get benefited out of all those courses. So let's start with a simple thing. Basically, as we are aware, what exactly is Coursera? Basically, Coursera is a worldwide online learning platform founded in 2012 by Stanford computer science professors Andrew Ng and Daphne Koller that offers massive open online courses, specializations and various degrees. Now this Coursera is something a worldwide online learning platform. Now anybody who has access to this Coursera and gets a certificate under Coursera has a recognition in all the industries. In fact, he has a recognition in various parts of industries, whether it could be in academia or whether it could be an industry. Now, like I was telling, Coursera is a worldwide online learning platform, and just imagine how if that Coursera learning platform is provided to you guys, that is to the students of VDIT, which is in a very affordable manner, or let's assume that it is given free of cost. So that's where this FUEL, that is Friends Union for Energizing Lives, this is basically an NGO, and this FUEL has come up with a unique program wherein they have a tie-up with that Coursera, and they are offering this Coursera courses, or basically the courses which fall under Coursera, completely free of cost for the students of KLS VDIT, and it will be completely for the benefit of you guys. So this is what I just wanted to tell you guys, how you can make best use of the complete FUEL Coursera online courses for the upcoming career benefits. Now before proceeding, how do I do the registration, what are the courses available, and what will I be doing once I start enrolling the courses, how will be the mode of examination, what will be the certifications, before getting into all those aspects, let's begin with on a simple note, why FUEL. Now basically, lack of clear information on education and career opportunity is one of the major obstacles before all the students. Now this prevents most of us from reaching the right opportunity at the right time. In fact, complicated documentation processes and foggy system formalities restrict the progress of brilliant students, which hampers the country's growth. Now this is where FUEL pops in. Maleducation is a problem where students are unable to choose the correct education and career path suitable for their interest and aptitude, primarily because of lack of information. Now that's where again FUEL pops. FUEL has a very systematic way of reaching out to the student fraternity with a good amount of data, statistics and documentation, which is generated with thousands of hours of R&D in various streams. That's the reason why we as an institute is having a tie-up with the FUEL, wherein the FUEL has bought you all the courses under Coursera and making you industry ready. And we should be very proud of Mr. Ketan Deshpande, who is the CEO of FUEL NGO, and with his great efforts, he could be able to find such a novel institute which completely bridges the gap between industry and academia. So this is why we are opting for FUEL. Now, what are the initiatives from KLS VDIT and what we are supposed to do, or we as a student are supposed to do, and how it is going to benefit all of us? Basically, in this aspect, VDIT has taken up an initiative to make two such courses under Coursera a compulsory one, meaning you will be allowed to take two compulsory courses which we are going to link with your academic subjects in the form of assignments. Not only we are linking, we are allocating 20 marks for each course you enroll. So basically, to summarize, it's just like this. You are free to take up n number of courses you want, but you are supposed to take two courses which are mandated by the institute in this regard. Now, what will be the two courses? Now, basically, my two courses are Machine Learning for All, which is of 22 hours of duration, and Learn to Program the Fundamentals, which is of 25 hours of duration. Now, why again these two courses are being chosen? It's mainly looking at the present industrial expectations and looking at the present trend in the industry. And after a lot of discussion with learned people, we have decided to make these two courses as a compulsion one, and all of you will be opting these two courses. Now, when I say all of you, it is irrespective of branches. It could be from CSE, or you could be from CSE, ECE, mechanical, civil, electrical, no matter from which branch you are. We feel it is a need of the hour that one should be an interdisciplinary person, or basically today's engineer must be an interdisciplinary person, who should have knowledge of all aspects of updated technologies. So that's the reason we are floating these two courses as a compulsion course for all the students. Now, apart from these two courses, as I told, there are n number of courses. One could browse through all these courses and they can easily opt for any of the courses they would like to choose, which could definitely enhance their resume, or which could enhance their skills. But these two courses will be a compulsion one. Now, for each course a student enrolls, for example, you will be getting 2.5 marks out of 10 marks assignment for all the subjects. I mean, just it's just like since we told that there will be two courses, and I also told that all these two courses are being linked with your subjects in the form of assignment marks. So how it is going to work, or how we are making this linked with your assignment marks? So basically, we have six subjects and two labs. Now, basically, this whatever thing I'm talking with respect to final year, and in fact with respect to pre-final year students, or basically the upcoming final year and upcoming pre-final year students. So usually we have six subjects and two labs. So altogether I can consider you have six subjects, or six courses, or six academic subjects. Now, in each subject under your present scheme, you have 10 marks being allocated for your assignments. Now, what we have done is, out of 10 marks from each subject, we are taking up 2.5 marks and we are awarding in all the subjects including lab a 2.5 marks for one course you take from the Coursera, that is any one among these two courses. Let's say if you are opting for machine learning and you complete this course by taking up the certification, then you will be awarded 2.5 marks in all the subjects including lab. So which means altogether you'll be getting 20 marks as a reward on completion of any one of the courses. Now, since we have made two courses as compulsion, one has to opt for both the courses. Now, if he or she completes both the courses in the form of certification and gets a certification, then definitely he will be getting 20 plus 20. So 40 marks will be rewarded for completing two such courses which fall under Coursera. Now, when I say completing the course, it doesn't mean that you go through all the videos and you don't do the certification. No. When I use the word completing the course, it means certification is a must. The obtained certification, whatever you get once you complete the exam, it has to be sent to the FUEL organization and they will verify and intimate to VDIT. And once we get the intimation from FUEL NGO, you will be awarded 40 marks for those two courses, which will be basically 40 marks will be awarded for all your 6 plus 2 subjects in your regular academics marks. So again, we have a stringent rule over here. Basically, we are making all these courses compulsory, but there is also a deadline for it. It's not that I'll be completing at the very fag end of the semester. No, a strict deadline will be mentioned to you, and you have to adhere to the deadline, and you must be completing those courses within the stipulated amount of time. And you should be immediately taking up the certification. And once you obtain the certification, you should be able to send that certificate to the FUEL NGO. And once we get the confirmation from the FUEL NGO, you will be awarded 40 marks for two courses. So this is what is the basic structure, what we have mapped with respect to your academics and your courses that you take under FUEL Coursera courses. So these are some of the steps that you are supposed to follow to have the registration and to start with the courses. So kindly go through these steps. I'll also forward this PPT to you once this video is done. Before I go through all these steps in a theoretical manner, let's try to explore this registration process itself through a live demonstration. So for that, I'll try to demonstrate this entire registration process step in the form of live demonstration. You can just note down those steps, and after the end of the final step, you can see that how I can start my courses in the link in the Fuel Coursera login. So here goes the registration process. Now, to begin with, one has to use this link and to click this link. And once you click this link, so it will open up this particular form. Now, this is the form one has to fill using that click. Now, that link has been sent to all the students. Here is the mail which says it has been sent to all the students on June 15th. So it has been sent, and kindly check your mail in from the TMP cell. See here, you can see here the same registration link is there. So once you click that link, this entire form opens. Kindly fill all your details. Once you fill all the details, down the line, here is the college option. You have to choose this KLS BDRT. In fact, they have mentioned it as BDRIT. So just choose that and scroll down. Yeah, there is one more option called as KLS BDIT. So preferably you fill KLS BDIT rather than KLS BDRIT. Just try to fill this one. Now, many of you have registered and many of you have received a mail also. Now, this step is for those who are not yet registered. I'll come to the other portion wherein what happens or what should we be doing once we receive the mail. Now, this is the process which will be starting from the beginning. So, select this one and select your respective branches. Now, EC people should be selecting Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering. Don't select the other option. You can just opt for this. And you are pursuing year, and then the city where your college is located, it is Haldia, and then the state, yes. Now here, since there are n number of courses and it becomes very difficult to show all the 100 courses over here, they have made some 5 most opted courses by the students. Now here, everybody can choose either artificial intelligence or IoT, because anyhow the courses what we are floating are not mentioned over here, but we have received an official communication from them that the students are free to choose any courses, but their preference was these courses. But anyhow, you can choose select for time being artificial intelligence, and you can proceed further. Now here in the select mentor option, kindly select Mr. Sujit, because he is a spark with whom we are communicating these days. So kindly select this, and again don't worry. For those who have already done all these processes, you might have selected some other name. No need to worry. This is for the fresh registrations that I'm showing. Then kindly select your further occupation and then family yearly income. Please be specifically mentioned. Don't fake out here. And then you upload your photo and then upload your ID proof. It could be either Aadhaar card, PAN card, voter ID, and then mention a statement with respect to to company name which you feel it could be your dream company, and then area of interest or sector where you want to work. You can choose whichever you want to choose. So and then one most important question that it asks: are you on LinkedIn? Do you have a LinkedIn profile? And this is important for all job seeker students. If no, once you complete course, do make it and share it with us. So kindly, before pumping in with the registration process, if you at this stage, if you say that I don't have a LinkedIn profile or if I don't have a LinkedIn account, stop the process right now, open up new tab and just enroll yourself in the LinkedIn. Like I was telling, if you don't have the LinkedIn profile, try to create the one and then post your LinkedIn profile link over here, and then join the LinkedIn and Facebook pages of your Fuel alumni groups so that you can get regular updates, and then click on the declarations and then click on the submit. As soon as you submit this form, you will get a mail from the fuel, which will be something like this. Yeah. Invitation from fuel, Fuel Future Skill Initiative, FF Institute, FFSI. Now this is what the mail you will get. Now once you get this mail, click on this particular step one. So upon clicking that particular link in your mail, it will redirect it to the FFSI. So this is what is my FFSI, Fuel Future Skill Institute. Now here it is asking you to sign in to this particular web. You can see over here in the browsing tab, you can see courses.fuelngoindia.com. So official web page has been opened. Now just click on the sign in. Now you can see here why the LinkedIn profile is important, because it is asking you to sign in using your LinkedIn profile only. And then since you already created the LinkedIn profile, sign in with your username and password, and it will redirect you to another page. Now that particular page will have this structure. So this is how it looks. It has got two wings, online training and certification. Now let us not try to bother much with respect to certification, because certification part comes only when you complete a course. As of now, you have not started with course itself, so let's not try to worry about certification. So we'll just get into this online training. Click on this online training. Once I click into the online training, I can see over here there are two separate wings or two separate structures, one which talks about aptitude, one which talks about Coursera. Now this is what I was talking all this time. Now again, we'll get into this. You can just have a glance of this aptitude, what exactly this aptitude is, and what are the different courses that are present. In fact, they have different lessons, small lessons of 10 minutes, 15 minutes, and so on with respect to aptitude skills. And all students are encouraged to even learn the aptitude skills by logging into this particular structure in this particular site. Now, this is for your enhanced learning. One can always come here and learn. If you want to just see, you can just see over here. This is what I'll get. So this is what you will learn. You can see everything is being mentioned. So if I click on start learning, it will redirect me to the deeper website. I can see this is what I'm going to get. This will be your contents, and as of now, this is where I am being presently percentage. So if I just play it, it will play the video, and you can learn the things in a very interactive manner. So this is all with respect to your aptitude section of your FFSI. But I am talking with respect to Coursera. Now let's just log into this particular structure. So if I just log in over here, so a lot of courses will come over here. And now here, let's try to search for those courses. Remember, we have mentioned two courses which will be part of compulsion for your assignment submission. So what are those courses? Yeah, Machine Learning for All. So let's try to browse this course over here. Just wait for a second. Yeah, Machine Learning for All. I'll click over here, and then my course opens. Now this is where the enrollment has already begun. It has begun today. So you can just click on this enroll for free, and the course is all yours. Now before proceeding, just glance through entire page. They have mentioned about this course, they mentioned the level, approximate hours to complete, what will be the syllabus, how much time it takes, everything has been mentioned, and what are the reviews that have been given by different students or different persons who have opted this course, and who will be the instructor. And this course is offered by University of London. So this course being one of the most reputed course. So we can just glance through this and opt and start to study this course through this particular platform. So that was your first course, and we have other program, other course over here, learn to program. So let's try to search learn to program the fundamentals. Again, once you open this, it will start enroll for free. Now in every courses you open, you can see sponsored by Fuel Future Skills Institute. So basically, which means all these courses are being sponsored by Fuel NGO. Again, this is a 100% online course. What is the level? What is the approximate hour? What is the syllabus it is going to cover? Everything is being mentioned. So this is what will be your course structure, learn to program the fundamentals, and this is offered by University of Toronto. And like I was telling, you are free to browse all sort of courses. Look here, if I just click on explore, in different categories I can see different courses. You can glance through any courses, and you are free to choose any course, and you are free to do any kind of certification you want. But the courses which are being mentioned by the institute are mandatory. So this is how the entire registration process which I was talking here, this is where we end up. Click on the join Coursera, and in the search tab, if I search the courses which we mentioned over here, machine learning and learn to program, they will open up and you can enroll for free and you can start. So this is how this entire process works. Now in case of any difficulties and any issues, you are free to contact either the training and placement cell or your respective department training and placement coordinators. They will definitely assist you in this regard. This is how the entire registration process happens, and that's it from my end. Happy learning. Keep learning.